Once upon a time, there was a little snowman that was walking around the hallways of Burton Elementary School. He heard some amazing sounds all around the school. He was particularly interested by a group of kindergartners who were singing and dancing about him. This is what he saw.
Couldn't wait to explore more. His heart led him to a group of second grade students that were reciting a poem also about him.
Ms. Bayon and Ms. Governor's class are going to recite the snowman's resolution, written by Eiley Fisher.
The snowman had one chicken, and his nose was out of place, and several of his whiskers had fallen from his face. But the snowman didn't notice, for he was trying to think of a new
walking around made the snowman very hungry. What's that smell? Is it cupcakes? He followed the smell.
My name is Arlie from room 13. Our pastry chef, Miss Alvarez, is going to teach us how to make holiday cupcakes. We need 4 eggs, 1 cup of sugar, 1/2 cup of oil, 1 cup of milk, 3 cups of flour, 1 tablespoon of baking powder, 1 tablespoon of vanilla, and then we put frosting, sprinkles, and candies.
We all had a job to do.
Okay, so how many eggs do we need?
4
eggs. Okay, put them in here.
Cracking eggs is not as easy as it looks.
You have to make sure to keep the shells out.
We all got a chance to help.
When you measure, you have to make sure that you are precise.
You have to add the ingredients slowly as you make them in.
Miss Alvarez is very good at mixing.
Have a cup? Yes, perfect. You guys did good.
We added the oil slowly too. I didn't know cupcakes had all of these ingredients. It was hard to measure the vanilla. We also added the flour slowly.
Vanilla is very important.
It is not easy to put the batter in the little container.
You bake at home, Kevin?
Yes.
Mm, I like baking.
Oh wow. What have you baked before?
I used to make cupcakes. It'll be too high.
The cupcakes have to cool down before you decorate them. We have fun decorating the cupcakes. Making cupcakes from scratch is fun.
Happy holidays,
the snowman couldn't remember the last time he had eaten a cupcake. It was delicious. There was only one thing he could do with this sugar rush. Dance.
To the people, stop with your feet. Hands on your head.
Dancing made him tired. It was time to sit down and listen to a good story. Lucky for him, that's exactly what was happening in room 22.
Hello, my name is Jacob from Miss Perez's fifth grade class, and today we will be reading A Christmas Wish for Corduroy by Don Freeman.
One December afternoon, a toy bear in a big store was just waking up when he heard a mother asking a boy, "Have you decided what you would like for Christmas yet?" The bear sat a little taller and pricked up his ears. Maybe this boy wanted a bear.
But the boy stepped right by him and pointed to a bright, red, shiny fire engine. "I'm going to ask Santa for a fire truck with a big ladder and a bell," the boy said.
The bear watched sadly as the boy walked away. In the store that afternoon, the book at story time was about Santa and the elves at the North Pole.
All the children were excited to make Christmas lists and visit Santa.
"Maybe I should visit Santa," the bear thought. "I could ask him if he knows a girl or a boy who wants a bear. Tonight I'll go see if I can find him."
Just before closing time, a girl stopped right in front of the bear. "Maybe she wants a bear," he hoped, but the girl pointed to a doll in a pink dress.
"Mommy, look, a pretty Piper doll. That's the doll I'm gonna ask Santa to bring me when I see him." "Make sure you put her name on your list, dear," said her mother. "And if you are going to see Santa, we should get you a special outfit."
"A special outfit? I didn't know that I need a special outfit to see Santa. Does the bear have his look or his brown fur? Why I don't have any clothes? Oh. And without a name, how can ever be anyone's Christmas list?"
Late that evening, when all the shoppers had gone home, the bear climbed down from his shelf. The store seemed much bigger without any people in it. There were strange shadows everywhere. The bear felt very small.
He found a department that sold hats. "Those hats look pretty special," he said. He tried on all kinds of hats, but none of them seemed quite right for a bear who was looking for Santa. Next to the hat department was the shoe department. "A pair of shiny new shoes would make me look special," thought the bear. But all of the shoes were much too big.
Then he spotted the children's clothes department. Surely he would find an outfit there. But the only clothes his size were the baby clothes. So the bear kept looking.
Up ahead, he saw a sign with Santa's picture on it. "This must be the way out to the North Pole. That's just where I want to go." He followed the sign until he almost bumped into a reindeer.
"The North Pole looks exactly like it did in the book," said the bear. "There are trees with reindeer and a workshop for Santa." He went inside to take a look.
"This is a very little workshop," said the bear. He sat down in the chair. It was the perfect size. He looked around the room. There were small toys, tools, and even some elf clothes hanging on the wall. That gave him an idea.
First, he tried on an elf hat, but his ears were too small. Then he tried on a pair of elf shoes, but his furry bear paws were too big. Finally, he tried on the elf clothes. They fit perfectly. Now, unbuttoning and unbuttoning anything with bear paws is not easy. And one button almost fell off before the bear finally got the overalls on.
"These overalls are just the right kind of special for me," thought the bear. As he looked at himself in a mirror, "Now I am really ready to meet Santa." Then he noticed a big chair nearby. "That must be Santa's chair," said the bear. "I will wait here, so I will be first in line. When Santa comes, and then I can ask him for a little girl or a boy to take me home."
By now, it was very late, and the bear was very tired. He climbed up onto the chair, and before long, he was fast asleep. That is exactly where Santa found him the next morning. "Good little fellow, how did you get up on my chair? Those are mighty fine green corduroy overalls you are wearing. A good-looking bear like you should be with the other toys. Mrs. Claus, would you please bring corduroy back to the toy department?" asked Santa.
"Santa called me corduroy," thought the bear. "I have a name. Now I can be on someone's Christmas list." The bear was finally ready to tell Santa his Christmas wish.
But before Corduroy could say a word, he was on his way back to the toy department with Mrs. Claus, past the clothes, past the shoes, and past the hats, farther and farther away from Santa until he was back where he started. "We found Corduroy Bear on Santa's chair this morning," Mrs. Claus explained to the sales lady. "Doesn't he belong in your department?"
The sales lady looked at Corduroy in his new green overalls. "You do look familiar," she said as she put him on the shelf. That is just where Corduroy Bear was later that day when a mother and daughter walked into the toy department.
The little girl stopped and looked straight into Corduroy's bright eyes. "Oh, Mommy," she said, "look, there's the very bear I've always wanted."
Her smile made Corduroy feel more special than all the names and outfits combined.
"This must be what Christmas feels like," thought Corduroy. He smiled his best. Bear smiled right back.
What is in the minds of students this time of the year? The snowman wondered. His wondering led him to room 21. And this is what he heard.
"My favorite Christmas tradition is going to church and open presents with my family. I love to hang out with my family and take a break from school."
"Mi tradición navideña es esperar a Santa si viene. Y mientras espero a Santa, estoy con un vaso de leche y galletas de chocolate. Y también, si no viene Santa, me como las galletitas ya que no vino Santa.
My favorite tradition is to make a gingerbread house with my family and make a fort to sleep on Christmas Eve. Last is to decorate my Christmas tree as well as my house.
I have a lot of Christmas traditions, and two of them are eating dinner with my extended family and opening presents with them. Our tradition in dinner is chicken with ham.
My favorite part about the holidays is to make breakfast with my mom. A second thing that we do for the holidays is watch movies and play games. Another holiday tradition is to open my presents in the morning. Thank you.
My favorite part about Christmas is playing the Hungry Hippo with my family. And first thing, I like opening presents at the morning. And I like eating like a family at home. And the third thing, I like decorating the tree with my family. And the last thing, I like waking up to see Santa Claus.
My favorite holiday tradition is I wake up early and I wait for my other brothers to wake up so we can open our presents. And on Christmas Eve, I eat with my cousins and my family.
My favorite holiday tradition is decorating the Christmas tree. And I go to my grandma's at midnight to open some presents, and then we all decorate Christmas cookies.
My favorite Christmas tradition is to open presents after dinner, and then after I play with my little cousins.
My favorite holiday tradition is eating food with my family and open presents and play with the snow and go on Christmas Eve and open presents with my aunts.
What I like about Christmas Eve is that it is my sister's birthday on Christmas Eve. What we do is we drink hot cocoa and get her favorite thing. We also get to open our presents after her, and I hope you have a good Christmas.
My favorite part about Christmas is that I decorate the Christmas tree. Also, I like to put up cookies for Santa. And I like to open presents with my family and cousins.
My favorite holiday tradition is waking up and playing Call of Duty with my sister and my cousin, and me and my cousin lay on my big sister's bed, and together we play and it's fun.
My favorite part about Christmas Eve is to see what type of presents I get. Another one of my favorite things to do on Christmas is to stay up until midnight to see what type of presents I get. My last favorite thing to do on Christmas Eve is to eat dinner with my entire family.
My favorite holiday tradition is eating food with my family and opening presents and making gingerbread houses. I like to sleep on the couch to see Santa.
My favorite holiday tradition is making cookies and opening presents and eating food and Christmas decorating.
My favorite part about Christmas is I get to stay up late. I can play Fortnite until it's time to open the gifts.
On Christmas Eve, my family and I do is making some cupcakes. I love when we go to my cousin's house and open some gifts and see what me and my family get.
My favorite holiday tradition is opening presents at midnight and eating tamales.
My favorite part of Christmas is when we play board games together, and sometimes we make tamales with my tia. Also, we like to watch movies together.
He realized that the holiday season is very important for many, many children. This made him want to learn more about the holidays around the world. This is a school. Surely he would find this information nearby. It was all next door in room 20.
So many winter holidays are celebrated around the world. My class and I have done some Googling and have lots to tell you. Let's start with Christmas and see where it takes us.
Did you know Christmas is celebrated in 160 different countries around the world?
People around the world celebrate by decorating trees and putting lights on their homes to brighten the dark winter.
Christmas is a bright and happy time of year to be with family and friends.
Plus, there's gingerbread houses, eggnog, yule logs, holiday shopping, Christmas cards, singing carols, candy canes, reindeers, church, more shopping, plus holiday movies, shows, and parades.
And Santa!
Santa!
Long time ago, St. Nicholas helped the needy. His legend turned into Santa Claus, and he brings Christmas presents to the children around the world. Many people also celebrate St. Nicholas Day on December 6th, and they leave stockings outside of the hearth.
And Yule logs are from ancient Scandinavia's Yule festival. Many of today's traditions are. They celebrated the winter solstice with a feast that lasted as long as the Yule log would burn, and every sparkle would bring new life in the new year.
Ah, the winter solstice, the shortest day of the year.
So the sun sets super early, kind of like it is now?
Yup.
Oh, is that why all these holidays are centered around light and being with family all warm and cozy?
I suppose so. Throughout history, cultures worldwide held festivals and ceremonies for winter solstice. Most honored fire and light, life and death, the rising sun and the moon. Today, many cultures in the world celebrate light in the winter, like...
Hanukkah, the 8-day festival of light, celebrated by Jewish people. They light candles for 8 days, give gifts, spend time with family playing games like dreidel and sing special songs, and eat latkes. Yum! Hanukkah gal is given to kids.
Kwanzaa also uses lights. Dr. Karen introduced the festival in 1966 to the United States. To welcome the first harvest, it is based on African harvest festival traditions.
Also Diwali, which means the glow of light, and is a Hindu holiday where people light small clay and to symbolize the victory of good over evil. It is celebrated by lightning fireworks, wearing new clothes, and sharing sweets with family and friends.
From Yule logs to candles to twinkle lights, around the world, people bring light into their winter holidays.
But wait, aren't you gonna tell about more ways Christmas is celebrated?
Sure.
In the Philippines, they celebrate by putting up beautiful native lanterns called Patrols Plus. They have fiestas, give gifts. They have lots of fun with competitive karaoke. And the celebrations continue into the first week of January with the celebration of Feast of the Three Kings, Maligayang Pasko.
Three Kings Day celebrates the day they found baby Jesus. It is celebrated on January 6th in lots of places. In Latin America, they eat a slice of rosca. Whoever gets the toy has to make tamales for everyone on February 2nd. Three Kings Day is 12 days long, aka the 12 days of Christmas. In Spain, the kids get their Christmas presents. Many of these people also celebrate Los Posadas.
Posadas is a 9-day celebration of Christmas stories, so each evening a small child dresses as an angel. These people and musicians through the streets of the town visiting homes to ask for a place for Joseph and Mary.
Guatemalans also enjoy a variety of desserts and meals for Christmas like borrajas and buñuelos and tamales. Many homes decorate with chiribisco, birchol, long strands of chamomile, and pine needles.
In El Salvador, they toast Christmas with firework displays on December 24th and 25th. Feliz Navidad!
Many of them celebrate Christmas on January 6th with lots of rice pudding and dancing. You might see Winter Father when he comes on New Year's Eve with presents. Shon Arbor.
In Russia, on New Year, if children hold hands with each other and stand around the Christmas tree on the New Year tree, and called out of Grandfather Frost and Snegurechka to come and bring them presents. So it's just the bombas.
In the United States, New Year's Day celebrates the success of the past year and hopes for the coming year. In New York City's Times Square, at the stroke of midnight, they drop a huge ball and millions of people around the world watch.
Chinese New Year is the most important celebration in China and ends with the Lantern Festival when people go to moon gazing.
light lanterns, tow riddles, and watch lion dances and eat rice balls. Kids get red pockets and envelopes as money to spread good fortune and bring luck.
In Japan, Shogatsu is celebrated when temple bells ring 108 times. 8 times to ring out the old year, and 100 times to bring in the new year. Homes are clean and decorated with pine, straw, and bamboo for longevity. Kids get money and New Year's cards are open.
Wow, what I learned is that people all over the world have traditions and celebrations that bring family and friends together with love, giving, and kindness to light up their lives.
People are awesome!
Happy Holidays and Happy New Year!
Hanukkah, yes. He had heard about that before too. Do you think he was able to find Hanukkah music on this joyous campus? You bet he did.
Everyone dancing merrily in the new old-fashioned way. All this new learning made the snowman very happy. What should I do with all this joy, he thought. I know, let's do some more dancing.
Jingle bell, 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 snowing and morning, a bursting of fire.
Christmas tree at night. We are excited to put ornaments and lights. I put a star on the Christmas tree.
My family always counts back 25 days until Christmas. We get excited to spend time together. My mom and I wear the same set of slipper socks. After church, I hope I go ice skating with my whole family this year.
My mom, dad, and Teal always take me to go see Santa Claus. Sometimes I tell him what I want. Till Carlos's, I open presents and my family.
My whole family decorates our Christmas tree together. My grandma and my grandpa help too. We all open presents at night.
Every year, I get very excited to see all the presents under the tree. I go look at them every day until I can open them on Christmas.
Mi familia y yo somos nuevos de los Estados Unidos de Honduras. No importa donde estemos, siempre nos gusta pasar la Navidad juntos.
Every Christmas, my family spends time together and we play fun games like Sorry and Jenga. Then we open the presents under the tree.
For Christmas, my family decorates the tree and I put the star on top. We put gifts under the tree to open together on Christmas.
For Christmas, my family and I decorate my whole house with cool decorations. Every Christmas, we all wear the same PJs.
My mom takes me and my little brother to go see Santa Claus.
Spending this amount of time with the students at Burton stimulated his little snow brain. It sparked something new in him that he had never felt before. Could this be what they call creativity? "I want to create something," he exclaimed, "perhaps a delicious smelling handmade decoration."
Here, it's asking for applesauce.
You need applesauce.
1 cup of unsweetened applesauce. Okay, is this enough?
Yes,
1 cup. Thank you, Gabriel. What's my next ingredient? I need one and a half cups cinnamon. Let's see who's sitting quietly.
This must be.
This is cinnamon. Ground cinnamon.
Cinnamon.
Okay, can you pour it in?
Cinnamon.
Pour it in. Oh, that's one. For
help
me.
Leah,
can you pour it in?
We will decide it.
Leah. Oh, pour it in. Let's see. That is, pour it in. That's 2. Help me pour this in.
That's too much.
Okay, good one. You want to pour it in? Edward, thank you for sitting. Oh, pour the glue in there.
You need glue too.
You need to put glue so it would stick together.
Can eat it.
Okay, good. Thank you. That's enough. Okay, we are
ready. Is that mommy
me? You know how to mix. Let's mix what we have.
Keep make everything.
Keep mixing? Okay, good one. Let's see. Okay, good one. Now, in order for sitting.
I want to use my hands.
If I didn't call you to help me with this, you guys are going to help me make the ornaments. Stick, wrap. Hold on, Jay, I'm gonna call you. So I need to put plastic wrap right here on the table. And let's see, we need to get only a little bit. It might be ready, it might not. A little bit, not much.
We are hope.
Okay, good. Let's turn it. And roll it again. Okay, good. Let's put that the star. Okay, put the star in. Okay, good one. Let's see if it's ready. Get it apart. And it's ready.
Like magic.
This one is ready. So, look, no touching. No touching. Thank you. Okay, thank you.
I make a star.
Good.
Okay, press on it.
And I'm not gonna burn you, okay?
Press.
But I still am gonna.
Okay, thank you.
I have a burning house.
So,
and this is my star.
Pour it in.
Could you take him?
Edward, where did press on it?
Nobody.
Press on it.
Now,
you have to let it dry. If we touch it, it's going to ruin it. It's not going to be any good. You have to let it
dry
put
for
it in the garage for like 4 days. So, can you help me push it? Okay, we need to put eyes Okay, pretend. Let's see if this.
Is your house?
You guys, thank you.
Teacher, look at it.
So, here's my end. Here's my eyes on the end. Just around it. This, the edge, okay. And there's my Christmas tree. Like this, the end would be a gingerbread.
I can't reach that.
Gingerbread. And the gingerbread girl. So they get...
This was fun.
Little dots inside.
This is amazing. What else could he possibly create? An original story, perhaps?
How the Bear Saved Christmas.
Written and illustrated by Room 23.
One day, Burton Bear and his best friend Bianca Bee were walking through the Burton City.
They were walking down to the park and they heard a big crash. They walked to the crash site and saw Santa.
Santa said, "I'm okay, but do you see the presents anywhere?"
Santa was very concerned because he lost the presents in the crash.
He realized he needed extra help to find the presents, so he asked Burton Bear and Bianca Bee for help.
When Santa came to tell them, they were shocked. Burton Bear and Bianca Bee went to see the sled.
When they saw the sled, they said, "Oh no, our sled, it's broken."
Burton Bear and Bianca Bee asked Santa, "What can we do?"
Santa said, "Help me find the presents."
They magically traveled to the North Pole and found some presents there.
They said, "We have other presents. Let's get out of here. I'm freezing." They checked out some of the local stores for the lost presents.
They passed by an alleyway and found two presents behind hissing cats.
"We found another missing presents. Let's go to Santa," they said. They walked back to Santa. "Ho, ho, ho, did you guys find the presents?"
"Yes, we found all the presents. Let's go fix the sled so you can deliver the presents," said Burton.
They fixed the sled with some holiday magic.
Santa thanked Burton and Bianca.
When I get Burton and Santa delivered all the presents to the kids in Burton City.
"You will always be on a nice list," Santa said as he gave them a present.
The end.
We hope you enjoy the story.
I think you're getting to know our little snowman now. What do you think he did to celebrate all of this creativity? You got it. He danced some more.
Now dance, turn, dance.
great adventures come to an end. It was time for Little Snowman to return home. As you may know, it is not safe for snow people to stay too long in warm places, such as Burton. As he walked out, he ran into a class that had a final wish for him.
Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad, próspero año y felicidad. Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad, próspero año y felicidad.
My favorite Christmas tradition is opening presents with my family Christmas morning.
Every year on Christmas, my family goes to my auntie's house and we all make strawberry, pineapple, and chicken tamales. It is my favorite holiday tradition.
My favorite holiday tradition is waking up early on Christmas morning and opening presents with my family.
My favorite Christmas memory is when my dad got me the It Was a Prize 4-in-1 plane last year. I was so excited and surprised.
Last year for Christmas, my mom took me to the store so I could buy Christmas presents for my cousins. I love to see their happy faces when they open the presents, and this is one of my favorite Christmas memories.